Hi, this is Clarice from Equity Master, your go-to source for breaking down investing into bite-sized pieces. To stay updated, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Today, we are going to look at 2023's IPO from a rear view mirror, the best and the worst performing ones, and understand what lessons we learn from them, which can be implemented in 2024. So, let's begin. You see, the IPO markets in 2023 made a hushed start. In the initial months, we saw a muted atmosphere, but as time unfolded, so did the narratives. And in the recent months, the number of IPO listings have made a remarkable surge. Comparing the current year's IPO with the preceding year, the numbers tell a totally different story. In 2022, 90 IPOs made their debut, including both SMEs and the main board segments. Fast forward to 2023, we have 101 IPOs that are already listed and we still have 1 month to go. The journey started with 8 IPOs combined in January and February 2023. March marked as a turning point with 11 IPOs as market picked up pace. However, a dip was followed in the months of April and May with less than 7 IPOs each month. From June 2023, demand resurged and has remained resilient till date. What sets 2023 apart is that there were no blockbuster IPOs like the LIC IPO with an issue size of 210 billion. In fact, 2023 had a quieter trend with focus on companies from the tier 2 cities. To understand this better, let's look at some numbers. You see, till October 2023, 36 main board IPOs were listed. These IPOs collectively raised over 270 billion. Approximately half of these, that is 18 IPOs, came from companies located in tier 2 cities like Yatra Online, Signature Global, Utkarsh Small Finance Bank, and Cyan DLM, among others. Let's now look at 2023's best and the worst performing IPOs and look at the lessons we can learn from them. The first in our list is the recent Tata Tech IPO, which made a stellar debut with a remarkable 140% premium, marking the best opening in the Indian mainboard market in the last 2 years. The issue size of this IPO was Rs. 500 and upon listing, the stock began trading at 1200. This robust response is attributed to attractive valuations compared to industry peers and the strong brand reputation of Tata Group. Secondly, the P/E ratio of Tata Tech IPO in the current financial year stands at 32 to 33 times, which is significantly lower than its peers. With KPIT trading at 105 PE, L&T Technology Services trading at 40 PE and Tata Elxsi at 70 PE. The second in our list is Ideaforge, which made the second big entry into the mainstream segment through its IPO. The company specializes in manufacturing unmanned aircraft systems widely used across various sectors. Ideaforge claims to be a market leader in the Indian unmanned aircraft system market with an approximate market share of 50%. During its IPO, Ideaforge issued shares at Rs. 672 and upon listing on 7 July 2023, the stock opened at 1295, marking a listing gain of 92%. However, post its listing, the stock has been on a declining trajectory. As of 30 November 2023, the stock is trading at 782, reflecting a wealth erosion of 39% from its listing price. This decline can be attributed to a couple of factors. First, the stock is perceived to be overvalued during its IPO. Additionally, the company is facing challenges in maintaining a robust balance sheet and has been consistently reporting declining revenues. These factors have contributed to the downtrend in the stock's performance. The trend of hefty valuations impacting companies is not unique. We have seen such instances back in 2021 when startups like Paytm, PB Fintech, Zomato and Nykaa were listed. A similar scenario was repeated with Honasa Consumer IPO, the parent company of Mamaearth. When the company issued its draft red herring prospectus back in December 2022, it faced criticism from the market participants for its initial 240 billion valuation. Subsequently, the final valuation at which the company launched its offering was reduced to 104 billion, less than half of the initial valuation. Additionally, the size of the issue was also trimmed down. On 7th November 2023, the stock got listed at a 4% premium to its issue price. The third in our list is Utkarsh Small Finance Bank. As a small finance bank, it has achieved the second fastest growth in AUM from the financial year 2019 to 2022 among other small finance banks with AUM exceeding 50 billion. During its IPO, the bank had an issue price of Rs. 25. On 21st July 2023, the stock got listed at a 91% premium at Rs. 48. This premium listing was because of strong IPO subscription numbers and bullish market conditions. However, as of 30 November 2023, the company is trading at Rs. 50, which is very close to its listing price. Fourth in our list is Gandhar Oil Refinery. The company made a robust debut, opening at Rs. 298 per share, a premium of 76% over its issue price of Rs. 169. This successful listing is attributed to factors such as strong subscription numbers, attractive valuation, robust financial, and growing overseas opportunities for the company. The company's position as a leading manufacturer of white oils has increased its appeal among investors, contributing to the positive debut in the market. The last on this list is Cyient DLM. The company has positioned itself as one of the top performers of listing day gains in 2023. Headquartered in Mysore, the company serves as a reliable partner in electronics and mechanical manufacturing. It is a supplier for major players in various industries such as Honeywell International, Thales Global Services, ABB, Bharat Electronics, among others. Cyient DLM operates within a contract manufacturing framework, placing a strong emphasis on quality and customization to meet specific customer requirements. The share had an issue price of 265 and got listed at 420, reflecting a remarkable 59% gain. As of 30 November, the company share price is trading at Rs. 651, showcasing an outstanding return of 145% from its issue price. The outstanding performance could be because the company has managed to thrive in a highly competitive environment within the electronic component business. The sustained success in such a competitive environment is likely contributing to this positive momentum in its share price. Similarly, from the 101 IPOs, 84 are trading at a premium to its issue price as of 2nd December 2023. Now, let's move on to the worst performing IPOs of 2023 till date. In 2023, most mainstream IPOs opened either flat or at a premium to their issue price. However, there was one exception. Updata Services is one such example that opened at a 5.4% discount to its issue price. Market experts suggest that fundamentally the company was strong, but the public issue was aggressively priced, leading to a discounted listing. Second company in the list is Yatra Online. Yatra Online Limited also faced similar challenges and got listed at a discount of 4.3%, and to date, it continues to trade at a discount. The company's high PE valuation, heavy reliance on airline ticketing business, coupled with competitive nature of the travel industry, contributed to the dampened response of the IPO. Now the question is, what do we learn from these best and the worst performing IPOs? Firstly, understanding valuation is a must. From Idea Forge to other overvalued IPO stories we saw this year, it just goes on to prove that, be it renewable energy or some other hyped sector, it is crucial to carefully check the underlying company's true value, understand the risk, and go through competitor analysis. Before investing, just go through a few sections in the red herring prospectus. It will help you to analyze so much more about the business. First, you must check the About the Company section, where you get to know about the business, industry structure, market opportunities, and more. Second, check the Financial Information section, where you get the audited reports of the last 5 years. Third, check the Object of the Offer section, where you get to know where the accumulated money would be used. Fourth, Quantitative and Qualitative Disclosure of Risk, where you get to know what risk does the company see for their business. Fifth, Legal and Other Information section, where the company mentions about all the unsettled lawsuits. Remember, companies facing critical legal challenges may pose higher risk to investors. Doing all of this is very important because it will help you find the diamonds among the duds. Second, competition is real. Investors should check the competition in the industry before investing in an IPO. You see, competition is everywhere, be it for a well-known company or for a startup. Hence, winning projects can be tough for companies who do not have a competitive edge, and this will affect their profitability. Secondly, in highly competitive sectors such as travel and food aggregators, where competitive pricing is a key factor, investors should assess a company's market share in its sector and assess competitive edge before considering an investment. As an investor, understanding the company's position relative to its competitors is crucial in determining its ability to thrive in a market where pricing plays a significant role. Third, the performance of an IPO depends a lot on the overall market sentiment. The success of an IPO is significantly influenced by the broader market sentiment. When the overall market is positive and investors are optimistic, the new IPOs tend to perform well as there is greater appetite for investment. Lastly, think of IPOs as a long-term investment and invest in it with the same mindset as you do for other stocks. Happy investing! This video is for information purposes only. This is not a stock recommendation and should not be treated as such. There is no opinion or view in any stock covered herein.